Hello, this is Dr. Z, and I wanted to share some ideas with you about how to set up the headings for the APA style that you're going to need for writing your master's paper. Previously in the templates, we had all of the APA heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4 all set up, but unfortunately, with the way in which we allowed you to do your work in Google Docs and then copy it into Microsoft Word, it doesn't use the templates anymore. So now what we need to do is take a look at how you're going to add headings. So if you'll take a look at the Writing a Grad Paper Portfolio RWLD, you'll see that at uniwritingseminar.blogspot.com that I've added something here talking about the 5 levels of headings. This is directly out of the APA style manual. And so this might be useful. Up here I'm talking about how they're formatted. These are some points you need to pay attention to. And down here is an example. And if you click on this, you can get to a full example of it. Anyway, let's go back here. Let's go to Microsoft Word. And what we're going to do is we're going to start out and we're going to create a heading 1. Now the heading 1 is bold and centered. And so I'm going to go up here, I'm going to highlight that, and I'm going to go up here to Format, and I'm going to go to Style. Now at this point, this is very important. At this point, I'm going to go to All Styles, and they already have things called Heading 1. So what we're going to do is we're going to modify the Heading 1. So we go to Heading 1, and now I want to modify it. And so what I'm going to do is leave it as Heading 1. I'm going to make it so it's only 12 point. I'm going to make it so it's a Cambria theme body. If you want to make it Times New Roman, you can do that too. We want to make sure that it's centered. And you'll notice that there's a whole lot of space right here. That means that I need to go in here to paragraph, and I need to get rid of the spacing before it. And you'll notice that right here it shows that there is no spacing before or after except for the double space. And so that's how we do it. We click OK. At this point, we say apply it. And you'll notice that it did that. It applied it, it centered it, it bolded it, exactly what we want. The next one we want is we want it bolded, but we want it left justified. And so we're going to highlight this. We're going to go up to Format. We're going to go to Style. We're going to go over to All Styles. We're going to go back up to Heading 2, and then we're going to modify it, and we're going to make that 12 point again. We're going to make it Cambria, as I said earlier. We're going to make sure it's left justified, which it is. We're going to go in here to Paragraph. We're going to get rid of the spaces in between, and you'll notice that's exactly how it is. Dupe, dupe, and apply. Now the next one we're going to, another thing we need to pay attention to, I just realized, is that we need to go up and we go up to Format, we go to Style, and you'll notice that these are blue. So we need to go and modify, we have to go in, we have to click on black, make sure that it's black, click OK, apply, and now it's black. And this one we could probably go back and change that to black as well. I'm going to go to this one. This one has to be indented and bolded. so I'm going to go up here to Format. I'm going to go to Style. I'm going to go to All Styles. I'm going to find Heading 3. I'm going to modify. Let's begin by turning it black. Let's go over here. It's 12. And we want to go over here. We want to change it to Cambria. And as I said, if you're using Times New Roman, you're more than welcome to use that. I'm going to go down here. I'm going to go to Format. We're going to go to Paragraph. And at this point, we're going to get rid of the spacing. We are also going to go over here and we're going to indent it half an inch, which is what we need to do. So that indents the heading half an inch. And we hey OK, OK, and apply. Now the next one, heading 3, or heading 4. If we go over here and we take a look at heading 4, it says heading 4 is indented, boldface, it's italicized. So we need to go back here. We'll go back to heading 4. We will highlight it. We'll go up to Format. We'll go to Style. We will go down to All Styles. We will go to Heading 4. We will modify that. We're going to make it black. We're going to make it bold. It's still bold. We want to make it Cambria. Because with the APA standard, everything, all of the font is the same. We're going to click on Format. We're going to go to Paragraph. At this point, we're going to indent it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're going to get rid of any earlier, any spacing before or after. So, that's it. Now, an important thing to point out is that when we look at these headings, this heading has a period at the end. This heading has a period at the end. This heading has a period at the end. None of these settings are going to get rid of that, or is going to indent or put in the period. Also, as far as how they're capitalized. This is all upper and lowercase, upper, lowercase. This is starting out with a capital, and then everything else is lowercase, lowercase, lowercase. Okay, well, I hope that this has been useful and that you'll be able to use this. And so now what you're going to do is you'll use these headings to label each of the headings in your paper so that you will be able to create an automatic table of contents, as you see here under the April 27th posting. I hope this is useful to you. Thanks a lot. Call me if you need any help.